Hello there and welcome to Stylirish TV, where today we have as guest Michelle Jackson, author of the book What Women Know. Hi Michelle, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
And listen, how did you come up with the idea for this book?
Well, myself and my co-author, Juliette Bressan, we write novels and we were colleagues in writing. And last year, during the doom and gloom of the recession, we decided, let's do something positive to help the women of Ireland to, you know, overcome all this bad media press, all the bad news. We're very resourceful as women and we have a lot of natural talents and, you know, we multitask very well and we're very good at organising our homes. And we said, let's see if we can suggest something that will, or write something that will help women. So we said, well, maybe if we gathered all this information, we could make a book.
Right.
So we started off sending emails to our friends and asking our family and work colleagues. And it was quite slow at first gathering the information. And then last February, we set up a What Women Know Facebook page. And then the whole idea just mushroomed. And women from all over the world started contributing, answering our questions, using it as a forum to explain and exchange ideas, and it really went from there.
I see. And what is, let's say, the main message of the book?
The main message of the book is about female empowerment and women feeling good about themselves, because there's never been a time more where women have needed to feel good and feel, realize their own strength and how well they do everything, and not to nitpick and worry about how we look all the time or how much money we have, or all not get caught up in the whole, you know, finances. You know, reassess what's important to women. And what we found was that women, no matter where they are in the world, they all value and cherish the same things: family, relationships, friendships. You know, we're very resourceful when it comes to managing our resources, our finances, and this is really what we found.
And you were saying about the Facebook page, right? So that was, let's say, the point of meeting for all the women.
Yes.
And were they, let's say, pretty honest in their opinions? Or?
Well, we found them incredibly honest. They gave us their stories and their advice and their wisdom that from their own life experiences. They wore their hearts in their sleeves. And one particular woman actually told us that while we were writing the book and putting up the questions, she was going through a marriage breakup. And the support she received from the page was enormous.
Yeah.
It gave her incredible strength and support. And that's something women are good at, helping each other with.
True.
And another woman wrote she didn't have the nerve to try internet dating until she had heard stories from other women who had successfully met their partners and gone on to have very successful marriages. So, you know, we've had incredible stories.
So it built, let's say, some kind of community of positive chain.
Absolutely, a positive discussion forum for women to express their knowledge and to help each other.
Fantastic. Yeah, absolutely great. And which is your favorite phrase in the book?
Well, we've had so many contributions, it's very hard to, you know, choose one. But one that resonates with me is from an interior architect. She's a designer, fabulous woman. I met her, and I interviewed her, and she's from Pakistan. But she said that what she values most, her most valuable possession, is her freedom.
Right.
So she had been through a very difficult marriage breakup, and, you know, to have her freedom, to be who she wanted to be, to work, to rear her family, that was huge for her. So that was very inspiring, I thought, and it's something we could all learn from: freedom, something we take for granted. And for so many women in the world, they're in different types of traps, poverty traps, you know. So I think
for some is a conquer, let's say.
Yes, absolutely, yes.
I understand. And you were saying to me that, you know, there is, of course, also some kind of attention to the health side of the women, no?
Yes,
finding, let's say, some nice suggestions for women's health as well.
Absolutely. Well, we divided the book up into 9 chapters, and we decided to pinpoint the issues that are most important for women. And they turned out to be love, beauty, health, money, sex, and children, and spirituality. So, you know, there's something for everybody in this book. And the health, yes, there were a couple of really, really important, eye-opening, amazing revelations, you know, about overcoming women's problems, cystitis and thrush. We've got women's own experiences and how they dealt with it and how they heal themselves, and little tips that you mightn't be aware of, but they're in the book.
Mm-hmm.
you know.
So again, you know, this kind of friendship
and
community,
support, yes,
yes
exactly.
Support, fantastic. And there is something lovely in the book. The youngest contributor is actually your daughter, right?
She is. Nicole is 6 years of age, and well, she just was very profound one evening while I was writing the book. She just sat there and said, "Mommy, what are you doing?" I said, "I'm writing the book and collecting stories." And I said, "Have you anything wise to say?" And she sat and she thought and she said, "Well, you know, Mommy, the whole world is a family. We just haven't met each other yet. Everybody is in the same family." So I think that were very wise words. And if everybody thought that way, there'd be less war and competition and fighting. And I think very wise words from a six-year-old.
Yeah. Oh, yes. And love, you know. Love, it's, let's say, something very important for all of us.
Absolutely.
Sometimes
men
we find
women.
Love, sometimes we don't. We feel loved or not, you know. Different sides, you know, of this. So what can you say, you know, from what you have heard from other women?
Well, that love is very important. It's as important to us, and it's a source of it's a source of pain, but it's also a source of joy. And whether it's love with your parents, your friend, your children, your partner, it really is the glue that holds us all together, and it's the most important message we can learn from life, I think.
So I would say that, you know what, I love this book, guys, so I suggest to all of you to buy this for Christmas, and you know, for you, for your friends, for everybody you love. So go and buy What Women Know Now, and thank you so much, Michelle, for being with us.
Thank
it
you
was
very
a great
much.
Interview.
It was lovely,
thank
lovely
you.
To meet you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.